Well, good day, Tubes. How's she hanging? Wet and sloppy and gooey and mucky and gross here. I guess it rained most of the night. I don't know. This rain this year, man, I'm telling you, if this... I guess I'll go in the back door. If this, this rain continues into the winter, into snow, it's going to be one of them years again. I'm glad I got that feller. Holy man. Holy cow, that's going to suck. And I bet you it's gonna too. It's gonna be one of them years where it's gonna be real crappy, wintry, and hopefully, unlike last year, come on, open. Hopefully, like last year, I don't have to shut the place down for like, you know, until it thaws out again. Had to last year because it was just, it was ridiculous. I mean, snow we had last year, holy crap, I had never seen that in my life, but last year was an exception, and hopefully I never see her again, but who knows. What they're saying, though, it's going to be a hard one, but they say that every year just to scare the crap out of you, so. But anyways, I got to go do a little bit of mowing first. I'm going to wait until later on in the day today to do the water lines, just, you know. Not like people are really going to water stuff. But when I was out mowing yesterday, I seen, or I saw people bringing in their mums, their, you know, fall mums, and of course they walk to the water tap, and I seen one lady over yesterday, and I don't know her or anything, but just by the way she walked over and grabbed the hose, it's like, I could tell she was like, really? I've got to use a hose? I could tell. Okay, I'm pretty good at reading people, and I could tell that she would have been, like, all over me if the water had already been shut off. But I didn't want her to water my mom's. Well, there's a lake with 250 billion gallons of water in it. How about that? But, oh, no. Couldn't do that, so. But the water was still on, and nothing happened, so everything was good. So, yeah. Okay, fire this guy up. So look at this. Last night's video, remember I showed you I chewed up all the stuff on the road? And over there, yeah, it's all coated again. There's still this tree that's got to come down yet. A lot of it. And then this one will probably be done maybe by like today. I don't know. Probably take a little longer than that, but it all depends on the wind. But that one's pretty much stripped, which is good. Sweet! But yeah, this one's like, it's always done that. It's 1, 2, 3. I don't know. It's always done it every year. And this will be like the last one to come off. So, but anyways, yeah, I'm going to go chew up some leaves. And I got funerals coming too. So I got to go do that one section back in there and get her all cleaned up and nice and looking good and stuff. And then we'll get working on our water lines, I guess. Blowing them out. Sweet. Well, I wasn't focusing there for a sec, but anyways, we're ready to go. Got my funerals done. Got a bunch of leaves chewed up. We're gonna need that feller. And I guess first we gotta head her over to turn off the tap. The main. Shut that off for a bit. The main. So we'll just throw that in her pocket. We'll head her over and we'll get that shut off, and we'll take off the main feed hose there and then put on the little stopper bung thingy, and then we can bleed out the system. So it's a good thing I didn't shut the water off earlier, because the guy come today to install the base for the new flagpole for back at the veterans section there, in the veterans plot there, and he needed water for mixing the cement. Very clever idea how he did it. Gave me a few ideas for whenever I do mine. Now, maybe not quite the same, but he dug a hole, basically like my cremation holes I dig, which is like a foot and a bit, you know, whatever, wide by about 3 feet deep. He filled that full of cement, And he had this great big, it was probably 24 inch by maybe a 1 inch threaded rod. And I had like the mount for the flag to mount to it. Actually, you can unscrew the flag again and it's on like a hinge, so you can actually push her down to the ground. I thought that was pretty cool. Why am I having trouble focusing today? I don't know. I apologize if sometimes she goes blurry and stuff, but I don't know, it's having issues today. But yeah, so that was kind of cool. So now everything is done. I'm shutting the water off, and I told everybody, water's going off. So over to the side of the building we go. See this? People actually used to come, turn this off, undo this, get their water and not put it back on. And then there's no water in the cemetery. This is like the thing for the cemetery here. Well, it's good nobody's been touching it because it's... Okay, so that's off. Everything's still pretty pressurized. So now we need to go around the front of the building here and turn the tap on and let her pee out until she runs out of juice. It shouldn't take too long. Ooh, free coffee. And bleed her off out here. Well, if you remember this video from last year, everything seems to be sitting all right. I put the wrong kind of grass seed in, though. It's just taken right off. So that'll sit there, and, well, that's about it. Alrighty then. Usually there's a little more than that, but... Well, I'll let that sit there a minute. We've got to go put our bunghole thing in here. And yes, I'm pretty sure I just said bunghole. Well, it's a bung. We got to put it in the hole, and it's a bunghole. So, bunghole. But anyways, big time. Okay, so now we got to tear apart this thing. And sometimes this is kind of ridiculously, insanely crazy. But hopefully today it's going to work pretty good. Okay. Twisting the whole hose here, eh? Okay, that can go in. That's good. Good. What that does is it takes that thing off. It's draining out now. So when I put the air to it, it doesn't out there and doesn't do nothing that way. Okay, so now what we gotta do is run down to that tree down here and turn off the tap going to the east side. All right, so turn this guy off. These are gate valves, so there's like a big door thing that gets squished down through there through a couple of channel things. Just make sure this one's open good. Yep. All right, now we got to go to the far other end and open up the tap. Oh, but we got to shut this one off. Okay. All right, now I got to go to the far end and open that tap. That's good, a little bit there, but okay, that's good. Now we gotta go back and put the pressure to her. okay, feller. I know you can do it once more, please. And, well, he's okay, but I'm worried about this thing overheating and exploding on me. But anyways, here we go. Gotta get this hose. Drag this out here. And this hose, a lot of hoses to have to go through, but it's about the only way I can do her. I think I'm just gonna let that thing charge right up first before I plug that in. Now I probably should be using the regulator on this, but I just pour it right to her. No big problems. Ooh. The only thing is this is like a 2-inch line here, so it takes an awful long time to fill that feller up. But this here, I haven't got those tanks. So I just be able to pressurize it instead of pressurizing these two great big tanks over here. This will be like probably way a lot faster and way a lot more better. And hopefully we don't see things coming exploding up out of the ground, because that would be bad. It means there's still that much residual, but it'll be draining down from the hill down into here. That's where that is. So that's not actually pressure. That's just forces of gravity, nature pressures, I guess you would say. Oh, there we go. She just finished. Okay. She's pressurizing, boys. Now we gotta hit her all the way to the other end again there. Back, but nope, mister. So anyways, that's gonna have to run I don't know, without those tanks there it might not be as long, but this used to be like 20 minutes of this just sitting here, but then it'll go like a big stream like this, and all of a sudden I'll go, you know, fine bits and blown chunks out. So yeah, it's gonna take probably 10 or so minutes anyways. I don't think we're going to hear the explosive of the pressure yet, but there's a lot of water. That's a lot of water. That's a long pipe from a long way. I don't know. It's probably 500-700 feet maybe. I don't know. But then I got like spurs that go off too, right? So I'm going to have to do them as well. And I do the furthest one, and then we'll go over, and then there's one over there I'll turn on, and then come back and turn this one off, do that one, and then go and turn the other one on, come back and turn this one off, you know, so they all get blown out, right? I just don't want to turn them off and let that pressure build in the pipes, because I don't think she's going to take that much. This these taps roughly run at about 60 to 70 psi, which is actually really high, but it's only because I want fairly decent pressure up in my house, right? This is all the same system here, so. Once I hear the first gurgle, we'll start filming again. But anyways, just as we're talking here, waiting, the way we used to do it before I did it with the air was they'd basically, slowing down a bit. Hang on. Basically what they would do was they'd open the tap at the very bottom of the hill away over there and open the one up here and then just kind of gravity feed it out. And that worked and then not worked. And just down in this section here, there's a hole dug with a like a drainer for this and out, and then it would just kind of all drain and then drain out. But it worked and then it didn't work. I had a lot of times where maybe I hadn't got it all cleared out, and then springtime comes and you turn the water back on and it's like, you know, there's water going out somewhere. So then you got to walk and basically look for like puddles like this along the water line, which kind of really sucked. But I've done it this way. This would be the fourth or fifth year now I've done it this way and never had a problem. Perfect, absolutely beautiful. So I just let her gurgle for quite a bit after, you know, make sure she's all blown out, because that 2-inch line, that's a lot of water there you got to get rid of. So eventually it all pukes out. So still working, still waiting. And I thought it was going to start to go there, but not yet. Oh, she just started. Well, that'll do this for like another 10 or so minutes, but that's some pretty insane pressure coming out of there. Like torrential downpour. I think that's mostly got it. There's still lots coming out, mind you. I'll leave it going for a few minutes, but unless it's building up another good one here. You have to trouble that 2-inch line. That's a lot of big line there to try to keep all going the one way, right? Huh. Definitely a lot shorter than it used to be, being those two tanks out of there. Hopefully, anyway. There's some more coming, maybe? See, all this little bits here, you gotta make sure you get all that out, or that's the stuff that'll... Oh, see? That's the stuff that'll freeze in your line somewhere and then make a huge mess in the spring. Getting the last little blobs out. Yeah, not too bad. We'll leave her going a few minutes here because there's not really air pressure coming out there yet. So, oh yeah, see? Found some more. Here's some more gurgling out there. Yeah, that would have froze. Sweet, still working. But anyways, I'll let this go a few more minutes. And I'll run over to the other tap, turn that one on. Come back, turn this one off. Let that one gurgle for a while, and the rest of them aren't too bad. This is like the worst one. This is like the straight line all the way to the garage, this one, right? So, but she's definitely gonna need a few more minutes. Either that or my compressor exploded and it's not pushing any more air. That could be. Could be too. Interesting. Yeah, something not right. I'm gonna have to go back check my compressor. That should be blowing a lot of air out too, and it's really not doing anything except a little bit of water. I'll run back, see if it's still running. Maybe it's popped the breaker.
Got her figured out. Marcel's doing a bit of work there on the Veterans Monument there. He had her had that tap wide open. I guess he was using a bit of water and he just left her open when he unhooked his hose. That'd be why. Okay, we should be blowing good air here now.
Yes, that's a little more better. I wonder why it had pretty much quit there. Now it's quit again. Oh, no, there we go. It's probably actually getting pretty well done. I'll let her go a few more minutes, of course, though, but, oh yeah, she's getting lots there now. Let her go until you get a good coming out, because then you know it's just straight air and there's no real water left in it then. So, pardon my French, she'll be a few minutes, though. It's either mud or it's blowing out rust. It looks like rust, actually, because of the water that's coming out is, well, sort of grimy-ish looking. That's interesting. That means it's really working good and blowing all the crud out of the pipes, too. So that's what I want to see. Some more of that kind of stuff. Yeah, the trouble with doing her this way is you open up one tap anywhere else, yeah, that's you're screwed at this end then. You gotta have her all shut except right at the end. That's why I gotta go to the other tap and then turn it on and come back and turn this off and then blah 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 back and forth, and there's a lot of running around here, but we'll get her. That's good, that's exactly what I wanted to see there. I let her go like that for, there's still a lot of water coming up here, right? So there's lots of water there yet. So I'll let that blow right out. And I'll slowly walk over and do the other tap, and I can pretty much look over here and see how this one's looking too. Isn't this a nice pretty tree? Still got pretty much all its leaves on it too. There's a lot to come off of this one. Oh, there comes some. But nice, I guess I'd call it orangey yellowy color. Some orangey up here, but mostly yellow. And the rest of these ones are pretty much following suit too, you know. Kind of nice colors and stuff. There's one here. Where the heck did he go? Oh, no, he has changed now. He has changed. There was one, either one of these, oops, right, one of these big guys here. It was still green the other day, but now it's pretty much done. So that's good. Anyways, now that one's blowing good air over there. Now, once you get that real good mist coming out, eh, you know you're pretty much got her. So now there's something interesting. I've never seen a tree like this. This is a supposed to be a red maple, but God, it's turned green. That's weird. This used to be like a dark red maple, which it's, that looks green to me. That's really weird. This tree has like changed itself somehow. It used to be a red maple, like a, what do you call a red maple, but it's like a real dark color like this. I don't know, that's weird. I don't know. Anyways, that one's changed too. Got some green still on him. Sort of nice. And this one's pretty well yellowed. I really like that one over there though. Look at that one. It's like fire red. Fire red. Fire red. And some of these other big ones in there are just completely bared right off already. They're done. They are done. Okay, so this one's got a hose hook to it, but I usually just leave that attached too. We'll open that. There'll be a little pressure there. Not very much, not until we go over and do this other one, which is way over there now. Blowing some good air there. All right, let's walk her back over, and this one all of a sudden you'll see a big blowing up everywhere. It'll be awesome. So I know I've been through the air compressor stuff before. I've, you know, got a new air compressor pump, blah, blah, blah. I had to screw around with engines and motors and stuff. I think, though, after maybe this year or blowout cycle, I'm gonna probably get something newerish. Seen them at Princess Auto the other day. Holy freaking crap, the one I want, but it's a great big tank that lays down, which will take up way too much room. That would suck. I would basically have to put it on like the other side of the wall, which would kind of suck. But I think for this project here, what I'm doing, I need a lot more air. Not more, but it pretty much melts down that compressor pump when, poor thing, doing this, it pretty much melts that feller down, so she'll be pretty hot when we go back in there. But anyways, that's pretty good there. I like that. So we'll turn this off, and we'll quickly zoom in over to there. It should be going there, I think. Just barely see it on the bottom there. Oh, let's hit over there now. So that's blowing out pretty good there. I'm going to take this hose off now, because it kind of sometimes restricts the flow a little bit and stuff. Oh, look at that. Probably gonna get this right in the unit. Oh, unit. So I'll let that blow out a bit, and then there's another line. Hardly anybody ever uses anymore right there. We'll have to go open that guy for a minute. Although I think that's on the same line, so we really probably don't have to open that. But maybe I'll just run over now and just give her an open for a minute, and then shut her down. These ones usually are pretty good. What I'll do is, like I've done this now, probably another, you know, 3 or 4 days after, you know, the stuff all kind of settles back into its valleys or whatever, we'll give her another shot right to that very end one. So, yeah, there's probably hardly anything here, so, okay, that's good. All right, so now I gotta let this one run for a minute while we go over to the tap over by that tree right there. And yeah, this one's pretty much dried right out now. Not even anything puking out of it hardly, so that's good. That is good. Okay, over to this one. Turn this one on, and then we'll come back and turn that one off. And that is it for this run of this side. So then we'll go back, give the air compressor maybe a little bit of a cool down. If it needs it, I don't know, maybe I will, pardon me, do the other side and just burn it right out. Then I can buy a new one maybe. Gonna have to probably, because it's just gonna cook that thing. But anyways, it is hard on it because I got her spinning a lot faster than it should. Like I got it pulled down so it spins like three times as much as it should. Plus then I got that 3450 RPM motor just giving her, you know. So I'm just gonna take this stupid hose off of here right now. I don't care about blowing this one out. It's a piece of junk dollar store crap. It's like hard. Okay. So we'll let that one go. And it's gonna be a minute probably. I have to go turn the other one off. And then she'll be, oh, here she comes. Ready, ready. Oh boy. Okay, let's go back, turn the other one off now. Okay, so that one's off. Now let's run over and have a look at the other one. Let it go for a bit, and then I can run back and turn the air off for a minute or two. Oh, it's more than excellent, this one. Nothing hardly at all coming out. That's good. It's usually that, oh, there's a little bit. By the time I get back up there, shut her down, she'll be good. I'm gonna go open the other side on the very end right now too, for the east side. Belt's not warm at all though, that's good. That means it's tracking nice. This is apparently, I don't know, it does reset itself, but I guess it must have to get awful hot. That's not too bad though. I'm probably got it geared wrong. I mean, I got a fairly big one there, and then, you know, whatever this is here, right? So the smaller you go, let me think, the smaller you go, the faster it'll spin this guy. So I should have probably gone with one quite a bit bigger than that, but then it wouldn't spin that as fast. It would take longer to build your air up, and it wouldn't keep up as nice. So let this cool off for a minute here, because this is probably, I'm not too worried about my compressor. It's just, you know, the fittings I had to use here. It's never blown apart here where I've soldered it, which is good. I must not get hot enough, I guess, but I don't know. She's pretty warm if the tank's, you know, probably 200 degrees there. Probably shouldn't have that so close, dumbass. But anyways, I'm just gonna look at this little compressor. Oh, big compressor that I was looking at from Princess Auto. A little expensive, but man, I'll tell you, you want air, let's have a read here. That's a picture of it, and that doesn't really give any justice. That tank is probably about 6 feet long by maybe 24 inches, you know, from the top here to the bottom. It's a freaking huge tank. And big compressor, big motor. I just hope I have power. Hmm. It says on there, factory wired for 230 volts, so I think I shouldn't have any problem. Like, they're not going to want to sell anything there that's like a four or a three phase power or two or whatever phase power, right? And of course, right now it's on sale. It's only 200 off, though. It's not really huge. But 120 gallon two stage cast iron industrial air compressor. It's probably way more than I need. Let's have a read here. Hang on. Oh. So industrial performance delivers maximum CFM at 175 PSI, provides enough power to operate more than one air tool or device at a time, no doubt. Cast iron industrial duty two-stage compressor pump features hardened steel disc valves, oversized taper roller bearings, full balance cast iron flywheel, if this means anything to you. Splash type lubricant, 230/460 volt. And it says factory wired for 230. So anybody knows what that means. 460, that means like three phase or something. I don't know. It doesn't say that though. Oh yes. Industrial class three phase electric motor equipped with a pre-wired and mounted magnetic starter. Okay, so that might still work. Uniquely designed metal belt guard improves compressor pump cooling by as much as 60 degrees over other belt guards designs. Extra large capacity 120 gallon tanks. So now, you electrician-y guys, if that says industrial class three phase electric motor equipped with a pre-wired and mounted a magnetic starter, it says factory wire for 230 volts. That's exactly what I've got running into this one here. Okay, to this guy. Now, would this big fella run on that power? And I know I'd probably need bigger, like, wire, but just the 230, the two hot wires coming in, is that all I need? What's it say here now? Tank size, 120 gallon. Air delivery, at 100 PSI, it's delivering 35 cubic foot per minute. At 175 PSI, which is where she shuts off, it's still delivering 33.6. That's like wicked huge amount of air. It's way more than I probably need, but this thing would probably start pumping this line out and it would probably shut off again. Voltage rating 230/460 volts AC. Current rating 25 amps. Running horsepower 10, 82 decibels. It weighs 909 pounds. How in the frick would I ever move that? You would have to have, I don't know, it'd probably have to sit in the back shop, the back side there somewhere. Holy friggin' crap. Okay, let's look at the next one down. Oh geez, I think even that one would be fine. 80 gallon two-stage compressor. Quite a bit cheaper. We are vertical, so it stands up like mine now, which would be better. 80 gallon, which I think this is a 60 maybe, so a little bigger there. Air delivery at 100 PSI is 21 CFM, which is 10 more than this one. I think this is like a 13 maybe at the most. Air delivery at 175 PSI is 20. It doesn't drop much. Maximum pressure 175. Stages 2, belt driven, 240 volt AC, 7.5 horsepower. I think that would be more of a better idea. Oh, I gotta get this one. Look at the dimensions. 38 by 29, 623 pounds. I think maybe that would be a little more better idea. Have a better look at her here. Oh yeah, there we go. Sweet. So that's got a lot huger pulley on the compressor, doesn't it? Wowee. I think that would be probably pretty good. Yeah, that would be decent, I think, that one. The other one's just maybe too big.
Well, I'm gonna go back at her here at this, just melt her down, whatever, you know. Let's hook this back up, and then we got to go back to those two valves. Make sure I turn this on, or I wonder why it's not coming out. Got to go back to those two valves by that big tree, cedar tree there. Turn the south off, and then turn the east on. Okay, we're good to go again.
Okay, let's open this guy. close this guy. And then we'll run down to that other tap. Good. Now she's being diverted and out this way. All right, next. Let this one go for a few. This is another fairly long line. It's not as long as the first one though. It's I don't know, it's probably, that one's full. Someone needs water. That's all we got left, boys. This is a lot of water. You pretty much got to do this in this part of the country. Holy cow, if you don't, she'll freeze solid, boys. So we'll let that run a few, and then, wait a minute, wait for it. It's getting louder. Here we go. Ah, I told so. So we'll let that go, and then I got another tap over by that tree there. We got to go and open that one, and then come back and close this one. And pretty well that'll do her. There's another tap way up there, but I don't generally bother with it. It's been pretty good because it all blows out through here. So the same thing again in like, you know, a week or so, I'll come out and blow her all out again, you know, and do this one and then that other far one, and she'll be good. Okay, I'm going to walk over here, I guess, do this one. Turn that one on. I'll just, you know, take my time walking over because, you know, the more time it gets to blow there, the better, so. So. That is going to be awesome. And it's a little early for turning it off, but better safe than sorry, you know. I mean, really, if you got to water stuff this time of year, like, what the heck's the date today? It's like the 17th of October, like, really? So I think we've done pretty good, you know. Like, I kind of keep an eye on things too, you know. If people are watering a lot of stuff, well, maybe I'll leave it on another few more days, right? But it's been pretty dead in here, so haven't been many people wanting to water stuff, so we shall shut her down. Okay, so this hose here. What the heck? Oh well. Hi. I would have blown the hose out, but I can't get that stupid thing off. They're filling their stupid water in buckets. Man. So we'll let that one go for a few. I'll go back over and shut the other one off now. So let's go shut the other one off. Okay, so now we're going to go shut the other one off. So I can't say I don't get my exercise because I've been walking lots today. That one's starting to chug. I can hear it there. So we'll take our time and head her back over. So how are you guys doing today? Pretty good here. Turning crappy cold and stuff though, kind of sucks, but next month or two we'll probably be shoveling the white crap again. But anyways, yeah, looks like that one's just doing a little bit of and that's about it. So we'll go shut them down here, let that other one blow for a wee while. Might leave this one a few more minutes. It's still getting a bit of stuff out here. It's not super too bad, but maybe what I'll do is I'll shut that off, let that other one blow for a bit, and then I'll turn, it's still getting a bit out here, yeah. Okay, I'll let that sit for a minute, let that other one blow, then we'll turn this one back on, go over, turn that other one off. Just walking back over to do this, what we said there before, turn that one back on, turn this one off. Just thinking, man, my piddly little blowout job here. Can you imagine having to do like a huge golf course or something? Man, that must be some huge monster air they got to use for that. Because, you know, that was a lot longer lines. Like what I did here was probably one fairway, you know, and they've got like, I guess it's maybe just separated into different systems or something, but that'd be a lot of freaking line to blow out. Holy crap. Craziness. Okay, I don't hear nothing there, so we'll shut that off. We'll go back to the other one, back and forth, And that should do it. It's a lot simpler, easier than it was the older way we used to do it with, you know, the gravity feed thing. You know, because you had to basically run around and pull all the drain plugs out too, which really sucked because, you know, they're in the ground like all summer, wet and gooey and blah blah blah, and then you gotta go find them again, dig that up, and then you gotta try to get the stupid things out, and some of them were only holding in by like two or three threads, and that was it. So it was kind of a nightmare doing her that way. So this way you're fully insured that she's all blown clean dry ish so I guess if you left it long enough, they probably would dry out on the inside. But so anyways, time I get back to the garage, builds up pretty good fast there, eh? Better not do that too long, because one of these spots back along here is going to go in the air. That's pretty good though. Okay, let's head her back to the garage. Well, that's it. Shut her down, and the rest of the air can just bleed its way out. Man, these things are in here. We are good. All right, let's roll this feller back up, and we gotta park the tractor then. So that's getting warm enough that I can actually feel it in this fitting and stuff here. It's actually warm, and then up to here, and out here it's cold out here, but so that's getting pretty warm. The hose is even getting rubberier. Yeah, that's pretty warm. That's pretty warm. Amazed it didn't actually shut itself down. Something's leaking here somewhere. Uh-oh. Huh. Weird. Way down here, not too hot down there, right about there, about halfway, she starts to get warm. Because basically it's going in here, and then it's coming out here, out this side, and then through the dryer, which I probably could have and should have bypassed that whole entire dryer thing, because I really don't need it. It's pretty warm. I really don't need it to get all hot like that, even though it's pretty warm. Oh, look at the water coming out of that. Well, I'll just let that air right out, I guess. Look at the, we'll call them stalagmites. It, like, leaked out of the threads of that thing. It's like, oh, I don't know what it is, but probably impurities out of the air and stuff. Ew. Anyways, she's dry. Now, that dryer probably needs the pellets changed in it. I got a box of them here. By the looks of things, they only last so long, right? They're only going to capture so much moisture. If you want real good dry air, you should probably run about three of these in concession, maybe. You know, out and then into another one. Blah, 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 and then out. That would get her pretty good. It's hard to get all the moisture out of the air, though. You really got to have it dry when you're using the plasma cutter. You're supposed to, anyways. And that is pretty much it now. Yes. So January 21st, 2012, when I put this all together here, it went to 0 to 140 PSI in 5 minutes and 33 seconds, so that's pretty good, really. For, I can't remember what size of this tank is now, I might tell you on here. 50 PSI. Nope. I think it's a 60, though. 60 gallon. It's not huge, but I don't think the sticker here would say anything. No, it's just a warning. I got a smoking hot deal on that tank way back though. I guess someone knocked the compressor over or whatever, or got damaged in shipping, and there was no motor or pump. I guess it fell over, maybe broke the pump, so they just took everything off. I got this for like $100 for the tank, so that was pretty smoking hot. Started off, built my first compressor out of a 100-pound, well, actually, no, it was a 40-pound propane tank. Then I went big time and got into a 100-pound, and the only compressor I had then was one that used to go on a truck. It was a like an air compressor for a truck. Down. And it was pretty good, but I wouldn't have never done that with it though. It was maybe, it was a twin cylinder, little wee pistons like this in it though. It might have been a 4 or 5 CFM at the most, absolute most, but it was wore out when I got it, so it was pretty tired then. But yeah, then I drove that one for actually quite a long time, and can't remember what I did after that. I think I hooked what I got now with a different motor up to like a 40-pound tank, and that worked pretty good. And then I'm like, oh, I need more volume of air, so I'm like, okay, let's get a big tank. And they sell tanks like that, but they're only like the primer red. I guess you paint them yourself, and they wanted like $500 just for that, so I'm like, what the heck. So I kept going with my propane tank for quite a while, you know, and then just happened to be in Princess Auto one day, and I was walking around, $100, they're coming with me, feller. So brought them home, and that's the one I've been running ever since. So I mean, that seemed to work fine there, but pretty darn hot. I don't know, scared of her melting down, you know, which potentially could, I guess. But anyways, I'm heading her home. Another week or so, we'll blow her out once more, and hopefully she's good to go. So farm sim Saturday tomorrow for yous. I got another burial here, so I'll be out doing that. But and then Sunday I'm leaving on a jet plane. See yous later. So probably the next actual video you'll see is footage of in the airport and going through, you know, probably after the security checks, once they pat you down and, you know, take all your guns and knives, grenades, razor blades, all that stuff off you. We'll do a bit of recording on that and maybe boarding the plane and, you know, finding our seats or whatever, and then probably take off. That'd be awesome. And the flight part will be kind of boring, so that'll be kind of boring, so then maybe landing or something, and then a little bit of that airport, and then it's gonna be awesome. after we get to the airport, it's gonna be awesome. You guys will see why. And then we're going to see my sister. So if you guys watch Go Pens Go 291, Go Pens Go 291 on the YouTube there, it's my nephew. He's making videos and stuff for you, so go check him out. I'll put the link down there if you haven't checked him out yet. Go check him out, and we're going to be going to visit him for only a week, so anyways. But I got like 4 people coming to cover me here. Can you believe that? I do it all by myself, you know. I live here on the property, do it all by myself, do all the burials, all the paperwork, all the everything, all by myself. When I go away, it takes 4 people to look after the place. Like, holy freaking crap. What does that tell you, you know? Like, it's either I'm really getting really, really overworked, or, whatchamacallit, they need that many people just to do the same job I'm doing. Like, holy crap. Not bragging or nothing, you know, but holy crap. If it takes 4 people to do what I do day in and day out, what does that tell you? Like, holy crap. Tells you how it's a lot of responsibility for one person, that's for sure. But honestly, I don't mind doing it myself, because then you're not stepping and tromping on someone else. That's, you know, if I had to get in the office to look up something and he's in there, or they're in there doing something else, it's kind of a nuisance, you know. So I really don't mind, but 4 people just to take over for me, holy freaking crap. So yeah, that's gonna be awesome. But we're leaving on a jet plane, and no, I'm not singing that song. So anyways, starting to spitter spatter again here. Man, spitter spatter, go away. getting tired of this bitter spattering, but soon it's going to be white and fluffy, which is really going to suck. But anyways, yeah, farm sim Saturday, up tomorrow. Pretty good. Had fun doing her. It was good. And I'm actually just working a little bit tonight too. Done a little bit already for another video for Call of Duty for yous. I think I've almost got up to an hour on video footage of that, so I'll probably just go another mission or two and then that'll be good. Render it up and then I got to get that uploaded. Oh yes, and video wise for which I was mentioning there for the airport and stuff, I don't know exactly when that'll be up. I know my nephew uses, of course, a computer to render his stuff, but I'm not sure what programs he's using, so I might actually take my Movie Studio Platinum with me, install it maybe on his computer, or might have to splurge and buy myself a laptop out there. Kind of gonna be kind of sucky. I had a laptop, but something happened to the where the plug plugs into the actual computer part, and every time you plug it in, as if you're charging a battery, like smoke comes out. So pretty much scrapped that one, which kind of really sucks because it was a really good laptop. But I'll just get something out there maybe that I can just render some stuff with, and then maybe just leave it out there for them or something, they can use it, you know. I don't know, like I'm probably not going to be able to bring it home kind of thing, because I only got so much room, right? So I'll probably just leave it out there for them, and then if they want to use it or whatever. I know they got laptops out there anyways, but my nephew's dad or my brother-in-law, he actually works at a computer place, so maybe I'll sweet talk him into picking me up something sweet. But anyways, or I might just run to Future Shop and totally tick him off, because you know, he actually distributes computers and laptops and stuff for like Staples and stuff like that. I'm not sure if he does the Future Shop. He might though, so I don't know. Maybe I'll get a better deal through there, but we'll have to talk about that when we get out there. So anyways, you've seen, if you watch his videos, you've seen him in a couple of his videos. Real short guy. He's not gonna like that. If he's watching this, he's not gonna like that. But he's a super good guy. There's some icing on the cake, buddy. And yeah, so I'm still gonna get beat up when I get out there. I could just tell it. Good luck, buddy. Good luck with that one. But anyways, it's really kind of getting crappy out here. It's been crappy out here like this all freaking day, and it really, oh, the light comes on. I thought, holy cow, the light has come on, but no. Anyways, so yes, anyways, that's it, I guess, for today. Farm sim Saturday, tomorrow. I'm gonna see, I'll get the Call of Duty up for Sunday, and we're gone Sunday, so it probably won't be Sunday. I'll get that video up for you about the airport stuff. I doubt it. Might be more into like Monday night kind of thing. So I'm going to take my two cameras. I got three or four batteries. I can't remember now. And I just got a spasm in the back. Three or four batteries and two cameras. Usually probably only use one, but just in case, you know, one craps out. And I got my 64 gigabyte card, which should be tons, because I've been shooting all day. We've done a fair bit, and I've still got 5 hours, 1 minute. Like, really? That's probably lots. And, yeah, I'll probably have to buy a laptop out there or something to edit and stuff on. And go from there. So, anyways, we're going to be doing some pretty sweet things out there. 100%, not 100% sure exactly what now yet, but I'm sure we'll find something super awesome to do. And yeah, so anyways, that's it. We'll catch you when we're in the air, I guess, or at the airport, and hitting her up. That's the next time you'll see us, and yeah, should be awesome. But anyways, we will catch you probably Monday nightish, I'm thinking, hopefully. It all depends how computery wise and stuff things go. So anyways, thanks for watching today. Hope you enjoyed her. Another good job done there, blowing them water lines out. That's a fairly bigger, major, important one to get her done before the real cold sets in, which I think we got her, so that's good. But probably later on we'll give her another shot there and blow the rest of her out. And just because sometimes in some of the taps, some stuff will settle in there and it'll kind of trickle down into the main line again and then just blow her out again and it should be good. So anyways, yep, thanks for watching today. We'll catch you tomorrow for Farm Sim Saturday and Monday night, hopefully-ish, for some airport and airplane stuff. Should be awesome. I'm not too sure what kind of airplane. I think it's a 737, though. Hour and three quarters to get there. Sure, freaking a lot better than 18, 20 hours driving, because that sucks. I'm never freaking doing that again. Driving, that sucks. Oh, I don't mind from here to, like, just getting into the Quebec area. The French stuff totally sucks. I do apologize if you live in Quebec and you're a French guy, but you guys suck. Your driving is horrible out there, and I really don't want to do that again. Montreal especially. Montreal, they need a big bridge to go right over Montreal so you don't even get into the city at all, because it's just horrible through Montreal. So if you've driven Montreal, you know what I mean. It's just a nightmare all the time. Rain's coming. Okay, gotta go. See you later. Thanks for watching. We'll catch you Monday-ish or Tuesday maybe.